Good morning students, welcome back to Max online class. In the previous class you have learned mensuration. Today I am going to explain chapter 5 coordinate geometry. I am going to start a new lesson coordinate geometry. In the previous class I have given some problem as homework. Have you all completed? Okay, very easy problem you have completed now. Okay, students. First, coordinate geometry. Devising a coordinate geometry. Here, x coordinate is called abscissa. X coordinate is called abscissa. Y coordinate is called ordinate. X coordinate is called abscissa. Y coordinate is called which one? Ordinate. X-axis and y-axis divide the plane into four regions. Please listen here. Here, this one x-axis, x-coordinate, x-axis like that will be say. This one y-axis, this one x-axis, this is y-axis. Okay, vertical line is called, horizontal line is called x-axis, vertical line is called y-axis. Clear? Then this x-axis and y-axis divide the plane into four regions. Okay, here the x-axis and y-axis dividing this plane into four regions. What are they? 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, next we can four region that we can say four quadrant like that. First from here to we have to start to, okay, counterclockwise direction. What is counterclockwise direction? Clock will move like this, is it? But counterclockwise direction means opposite directions of clockwise. Okay, this is called counterclockwise direction. So first this one, first quadrant. Next here, second quadrant. Next this one, third quadrant. Next this one is fourth quadrant. Okay, so this x-axis and y-axis divide the plane into four region. Next here we will be take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This one x dash sign, negative sign, -1, -2, -3, -4, -5, -6. Next here up of the line, here x-axis positive, down of the x-axis negative. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Here -1, -2, -3, -4, -5, -6, -7, -8. So from this we can say first quadrant both x and y-axis is positive. Okay, positive, positive. Clear? Positive, positive. Okay, like this you can easily, you can identify here positive, positive, here negative, positive, negative, negative, positive, positive, negative, positive. Next here first what is coming there? Positive, positive, negative. Okay, first quadrant, here first quadrant odd number both also positive, here first quadrant both also positive, third quadrant both also negative. Next here fourth quadrant, here first positive, positive, write it. Next negative. Clear? Next here first you write it first plus plus, here minus minus. Next here positive first coming, so positive, next opposite negative. Here first what is coming? Negative. So here also first negative, next opposite sign is positive. Okay, positive, positive, negative, positive. Second quadrant negative, positive. Third quadrant both also negative. Fourth quadrant positive, negative. Clear? Any doubt in here? First quadrant, the x-axis and y-axis divide the quadrant into which one? Divide the plane into four region, that is first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant. First quadrant both also positive, third quadrant both also negative, second quadrant negative positive, fourth quadrant positive, negative. Okay, negative x axis, negative y axis, positive. Okay, negative, positive. Here both are positive, 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 positive. Clear? Next here, negative x axis also negative, y axis also negative. So this quadrant fully negative, negative. Next here, x axis positive, y axis negative. So positive, negative. Is clear? Any doubt in here? Okay, don't confuse here. For here, first quadrant both also positive. Third quadrant both also negative. Second quadrant negative, positive. Fourth quadrant positive, negative. From here, I'm saying some notes. For any point on the x axis, the value of y coordinate is 0. Okay. Any point on the x axis. Any point on the x axis. Y coordinate. Y coordinate means what's that? Ordinate. Y coordinate is 0. That is P of x comma 0. Any point lies on the x axis. The value of y coordinate is 0. Next, for any point Q on the y axis, any point lies on the y axis, that means the value of x coordinate, that is abscissa, the value of x coordinate abscissa is 0, that is Q of 0 comma y, Q of 0 comma y. Next, x comma y, x comma y not equal to y comma x unless x is equal to y. For example, is it 4 comma 5 is equal to 5 comma 4? No, it's not equal. Okay, 4 comma 5 is not equal to 5 comma 4. If both are equal, means here we can say 4 comma 4 is equal to, but 4 comma 4 is equal to 4 comma 4. Okay, both x coordinate and y coordinate equal means only that is equal, otherwise it is not equal. X comma y not equal to y comma x unless x is equal to y. Next, a plane with the rectangular coordinate system is called Cartesian plane. Okay, this one, a coordinate, a plane with the rectangular coordinate system is called Cartesian plane. This we can say, what's that? Cartesian plane, like that also we can say. Can you able to understand this? Okay. Next, example 5.1. In which quadrant does the following points lie? A, 3, minus 8. B, minus 1, minus 3. C, 2, 5. D, minus 7, 3. Without plotting the points in the coordinate system, we can say which quadrant it lies, like that we can say. For simply we can draw like this. Listen here. It is first quadrant, is it? This one second quadrant, this one third quadrant, this one fourth quadrant. Okay. Already I explained to you, in the first quadrant both also positive. In the first quadrant both also positive. In the third quadrant both also negative. In the second quadrant what will be get it? Negative, positive. First negative, positive. Fourth quadrant positive, negative. Is it? Roughly you draw like this, okay? First quadrant both also positive. Third quadrant both also negative. Next, here negative positive first coming. Then negative positive, here positive, negative. Clear? Next, otherwise here also I am explaining that here first quadrant both also positive. Second quadrant negative positive. Third quadrant negative negative. Fourth quadrant positive negative. First question. 3, minus 8. Positive, negative. Is it positive, negative? Positive, negative means which quadrant it lies? If positive, negative means, fourth quadrant. Fourth quadrant, okay? x coordinate is positive and y coordinate is negative. So positive negative means in the fourth quadrant. Therefore 3 comma minus 8 lies in the fourth quadrant. Okay, 3 comma minus 8 lies in the fourth quadrant. Next, minus 1 comma minus 3. Minus 1 comma minus 3. Both also negative. Both also negative. Okay, x coordinate is negative and y coordinate is negative. So both also negative means in which quadrant it lies? Yeah, third quadrant. Therefore, minus 1 comma minus 3 lies in the third quadrant. Next, see. 2 comma 5. Both also positive. Both also positive. Positive, positive means the x coordinate is positive and the y coordinate is positive. Therefore, 2 comma 5 lies in the first quadrant. It lies in the first quadrant. Next, D. What's the question? Minus 7 comma 3. Minus 7 comma 3. Minus 7 comma 3. That is x coordinate is negative and y coordinate is positive. Therefore, minus 7 comma 3 lies in the second quadrant. Okay, second quadrant, negative, positive. Negative, positive, second quadrant. So it lies in the second quadrant. Have you all understand this? Any doubt in this question? No doubt, no? Okay. Now I am going to explain example 5.2. Plot the points A 2 comma 4, B minus 3 comma 5, C minus 4 comma minus 5, D 4 comma minus 2 in the Cartesian plane. We have to plot this in the Cartesian plane. Okay, first we can write the quadrant. Which quadrant is this? Okay, you can draw in the note itself, otherwise grab it like this. Take it and draw it and paste it in the note. Okay, if you are drawing in the note, plain note means also no problem. Otherwise, take the graph sheet and plot it and paste it in this notebook. First, we can select the quadrant. It is the first quadrant. Next, this one. Second quadrant. Next, third quadrant. Fourth quadrant. Next, here. Say that here 0. Next, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, minus 1. Here x. Here we can write x. Here x dash. Here y. This one y dash. So, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Minus 4, minus 5, minus 6. Next here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Next here, minus 1, minus 2. You don't use the sketch pen, you want to use the pencil and draw it. Minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8. Next, what we have to be plot that first point is, next we can write here both also positive plus plus. Next here negative, both also negative. Next in this quadrant negative positive. Next in this quadrant yeah, what's that? Positive, first positive, negative. Okay, positive, negative. Next, we have to plot the points. Which point we have to plot? A 2 comma 4. 2 comma 4, both also positive. First, you have to see in this x coordinate only you have to see. Many of them plotting wrongly. 2 comma 4 means 2 comma 4. This is wrong. Okay, first x coordinate you have to select it. 2 comma 4. This one 2, x coordinate 2, y coordinate 4. This one A 2 comma 4. Okay, A 2 comma 4. Next question, b minus 3 comma 5. B minus 3 comma 5. Minus 3. Where is minus 3? Here. Negative, positive. So it lies in the negative, positive. The question b minus 3 comma 5. Which quadrant lies? Yeah, negative, positive means it lies in the second quadrant. You have to see here. Listen. Minus 3 comma 5. Minus 3 comma 5 means here minus 3. X axis minus 3. Don't select this minus 3 first. First X axis you have to see. Minus 3. Y axis 5. Minus 3, 5. So which point? This is minus 3 comma 5. This is B. This is B minus 3 comma 5. Next what is C? Minus 4 comma minus 5. Both also minus. Both also minus means lies in the third quadrant. Minus 4 comma minus 5. So it lies in the third quadrant. Is it? Minus 3 comma minus 5. So minus 3. This minus 3 only we have to. Sorry, minus 4 comma minus 5. This minus 4 only you have to select. Minus 4 comma minus 5. Okay, first x axis. Next y axis you have to check. Minus 4 comma minus 5. So minus 4 comma minus 5. From here minus 4. Next from here minus 5. Minus 4 comma minus 5. C. It is C. Okay. C minus 4 comma minus 5. Next. Fourth one. 4 comma minus 2. 4 comma minus 2. Positive comma negative. Positive comma negative means which quadrant lies in the fourth quadrant? Lies in the fourth quadrant. 4 comma minus 2. 4 comma minus 2 means it lies in the fourth quadrant. Okay. 4. In the x coordinate 4. Here minus 2. 4 comma minus 2. Clear? Any doubt? Okay. We have plotted in the Cartesian plane. Okay. In the Cartesian plane they asked to plot the points A 2 comma 4. Okay. Here don't forget first x coordinate 2 comma 4 means don't plot this point. Many of the 2 comma 4 like that they will be plot here. It is wrong. First x coordinate A 2 comma 4. Okay. This one. Next, this coordinate also positive positive means first quadrant only. Next, negative positive means second quadrant. Negative negative means third quadrant. Positive negative means fourth quadrant. It will be lies. Okay. Any doubt in here? No doubt now? Okay. Now, I am going to explain example 4.3. Plot the following points A 2 comma 2 B 2 comma minus 2 comma 2, C minus 2 comma minus 1, D 2 comma minus 1. In the Cartesian plane, discuss the type of the diagram by joining all the points taken in order. Please listen here. First, I am taking a graph. Here this one, X, X dash. Y, Y dash. Here first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant. Is it? Next, here both also positive. Next, here both also negative. Next, here negative, positive. First, negative, positive. Next, here positive, negative. Next, here this is origin. Next, here 1, 2, 3. Like the number line 4, 5, 6. Here minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6. Next here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 1, minus 2, minus 3. Please listen here. A 2 comma 2. A 2 comma 2. A 2 comma 2 means which quadrant? First quadrant, is it? 2 comma 2. So we can plot which points. This one 2 comma 2. A 2 comma 2. Next one B minus 2 comma 2. It lies in the minus plus means lies in the second quadrant. Negative minus 2 comma 2. Okay. First you have to see x axis. Is it x axis only you have to see first. So minus 2 comma 2. So where it will become? Yeah. So B minus 2 comma 2. Next is C minus 2 comma minus 1. C minus 2 comma minus 1. Minus 2 comma minus 1. C. Next D. D which point? D 2 comma minus 1. D positive negative here. 2 comma minus 1. Okay. Next we have to join these points. We have to join this point. When we are joining, what will we get it? AB and joining. AB. Next, BC. Next, CD. AD. Which shape is this? Question is type of the diagram. What is the type of the diagram when we are joining? Okay. What shape is this? It is a rectangle. Therefore, ABCD is a rectangle. Therefore, ABCD when we are joining, what we are getting? ABCD is a rectangle. Can you understand this? Okay. It is not a square. It is a rectangle. Here how many units? 1, 2, 3, 4. Here 1, 2. Here 1, 2, 3 unit. Here 4 unit. Here 3 unit. So ABCD is a rectangle. Therefore the shape is a rectangle. Okay, here length is 4 units, breadth is, sorry, length is 4, yeah, length is 4 units, breadth is 3 units. Can you able to understand this? Okay. Now, I am going to explain exercise 5.1, second question. Write down the abscissa and ordinate of the following from the figure. This also in the question, okay. This graph also, they will be given the question, okay. We want to find out. From the figure, what's the P coordinate? Abscissa and ordinate of P. Abscissa and ordinate of Q. Abscissa and ordinate of R. Abscissa and ordinate of S. Here, listen here. P. P is in the P lies here. X coordinate C. What's the X coordinate of P? Minus 4. That is called abscissa. Okay. In P. NP, which one? Abscissa is? Abscissa is equal to minus 4. Ordinate. Ordinate is equal to. Y coordinate is 4. Y coordinate is 4. So, ordinate is equal to 4. Therefore, the point P is, what is that? Minus 4 comma 4. P is minus 4 comma 4. Next is second one. In Q. Q. What is the abscissa? X coordinate is 3. Y coordinate is 3. So abscissa 3 ordinate is equal to 3. Therefore, Q is which one? 3 comma 3. Q is 3 comma 3. Next, third question. In R we have to find out. In R. See that in R. Abscissa. What is the abscissa? X coordinate is 4. Y coordinate is minus 2. Abscissa 4. Ordinate minus 2. Therefore, R is 4 comma minus 2. Then the fourth question. Yes. What's the x coordinate of S? Minus 5. Y coordinate is minus 3. So, ordinate abscissa is minus 5. Ordinate is minus 3. Ordinate is equal to minus 3. Therefore, S is minus 5 comma minus 3. Okay, minus 5 comma minus 3. Don't write minus 3 comma minus 5. You have to write abscissa first. X coordinate is first. Y coordinate is second. So, S is minus 5 comma minus 3. Can you able to understand this? Okay, shall we go for the next question? Exercise 5.1 third question. The first one I will teach, second one you have to do for the homework. Plot the following points in the coordinate plane and join them. What is your conclusion about the resulting figure? This lesson here, first we can select that is x. This is x dash. Next here, y, y dash. Okay, x, x dash, y, y dash. The next is this origin 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Next minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here minus 1, minus 2. Minus 3. First, we have to plot the points. First, which point? What's the point? First point is minus 5 comma 3. Minus 5, it is the first quadrant, here second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant. First quadrant, both also positive. Third quadrant, both also negative. Second quadrant, negative, positive. Fourth quadrant, positive, negative. Next, we got to plot the points. When we are plotting the points, listen. First, minus 5 comma 3. Okay, first, I already explained that. X coordinate only, first you have to see. Minus 5 comma 3. Okay, here, minus 5 comma 3. Next one, minus 1 comma 3. Minus 1 comma 3. Third one, 0 comma 3. This one, 0 comma 3. Next, fourth, 5 comma 3. Okay, we plotted that. Next, what is your next? Join, plot the following points in the coordinate plane and join them. We have to join it. When we are joining, what we are getting? Okay. When we are joining, this the line is parallel to x-axis. Okay, y coordinate, all the point is equal means the line is parallel to x-axis. Here, y coordinate, all the point is zero, means the line is which one? On the x-axis. Clear? Here everything equal, okay? Y coordinate is same, means the line is parallel to x-axis. If the x coordinate is same, means the line is parallel to which one? Y-axis. Clear this? Now, what we can conclude? What is the conclusion about the resulting figure? What's that? The line is parallel to x-axis. Any doubt? Okay, any doubt in this question? I'm giving two problems as homework. Are you able to do that? Exercise 5.1, first question, and third one, second question, you have to do as homework. Okay? Thank you, students.